Welcome to the 50-hour air can service for RockShox rear shocks. It is recommended that this procedure be done after every 50 hours of riding to restore small bump sensitivity, reduce friction, and extend the lifespan of your rear shock. View a list of necessary parts, tools, and supplies in the video description below. And for more information, go to sram.com/service. Prior to servicing the rear shock, remove it from the bicycle frame according to the bicycle manufacturer's instructions. For shocks with remote lockouts, consult the service manual for your shock's removal process. Clamp the shock into a vise with soft jaws. Remove the end spacers. Use the RockShox rear shock bushing removal and installation tool to remove the bushing pin. Before beginning, record your air pressure setting to assist with post-service setup. Record your adjustment settings by turning the rebound adjuster knob counterclockwise until it stops, while counting the number of clicks. Turn the compression lever to the unlocked position. Use a small hex wrench to lightly depress the Schrader valve and slowly release all air pressure from the air can. Quickly releasing air can trap air in the negative chamber and cause the air can to forcefully eject from the shock upon disassembly. Do not disassemble a pressurized shock. This can cause suspension fluid or debris to forcefully eject from the shock. Wear safety glasses. To make sure all air has been removed, use a Schrader valve tool to remove and reinstall the valve core. Clamp the shaft eyelet into a vise, with the shock positioned horizontally. Remove the sag indicator. Insert a shop towel through the damper body eyelet to prevent the air can from forcefully ejecting from the shock. Use a strap wrench to remove the air can. Wrap the strap around the section of the air can furthest from the shaft eyelet. Turn the wrench counterclockwise to unthread the air can. The damper body may spin as you unthread the air can. This is normal. Remove the shop towel from the damper body eyelet. Slowly pull the air can along the damper body to remove it and the countermeasure spring. With the shock disassembled, this is a good opportunity to add or remove bottomless tokens for bottomless tuning. Bottomless tokens and Gnar Dog tokens reduce air volume in your rear shock and create greater progression at the end of the shock's travel. Add or remove tokens to tune your shock's bottomless feel. Gnar Dog tokens are equivalent to 2.5 bottomless tokens. To install bottomless tokens, clamp the shaft eyelet into the vise. Move the bottom out washer and O-ring away from the shaft eyelet. Then snap the token onto the eyelet with the tabbed side facing the air valve. Slide the bottom out washer and O-ring onto the tokens. Install up to 3 bottomless tokens. If you need to remove tokens to refine your tuning, move the bottom out washer and O-ring away from the shaft eyelet. Use a pick to separate the token from the other tokens or the shaft eyelet, then remove the token from the shaft. Do not scratch the damper shaft, shaft eyelet, or the eyelet O-ring. Scratches can cause leaks. To install a Gnar Dog token, remove any existing tokens from the eyelet. Move the bottom out washer and O-ring away from the shaft eyelet. Then snap the Gnar Dog token onto the damper shaft with the flat side facing out of the eyelet. Slide the bottom out washer and O-ring onto the token. The Gnar Dog token must be the first token installed into the eyelet. Any additional bottomless tokens must be installed after the Gnar Dog token is installed. Only one Gnar Dog token may be installed. A maximum of 2 additional bottomless tokens can be installed. Remove the O-ring on the outside of the air can. Spray isopropyl alcohol on the air can threads and eyelet body threads and clean them with a shop towel. Install a new O-ring. Use a pick to remove the air can wiper seal located in the top groove. Remove the backup ring from the second groove inside the air can. Use the pick to pierce and remove the quad seal from the bottom of the second groove in the air can. Spray isopropyl alcohol inside the air can and clean it with a shop towel. Inspect the inside and outside of the air can for scratches, dents, or other surface deformations. Replace the air can if it is scratched or damaged. Install a new quad seal by inserting one end into the deepest groove in the air can. Then push the remainder of the ring into the groove. Install a new backup ring by inserting one end into the air can. Then push the remainder of the ring into the can so that it rests on top of the quad seal. Orient the new wiper seal step side up. Install it into the wiper seal groove at the top of the air can. Apply a small amount of RockShox Dynamic Seal Grease to the quad seal, backup ring, and wiper seal. Set the air can aside. Clamp the eyelet vertically in the vise. Spray isopropyl alcohol on the eyelet body threads and clean them with a shop towel. Remove the seal head air piston glide rings and seal. Spray isopropyl alcohol on the seal head air piston and clean it with a shop towel. Install the new thicker glide ring below the seal head air piston seal and the new thinner glide ring above. Install the countermeasure spring. Apply RockShox Dynamic Seal Grease to the seal head air piston seals. Clamp the damper body eyelet in the soft jaws. Inject 1 milliliter of Maxima Maxim 4 Extra 15W50 into the air can before installing the air can onto the damper. Firmly press the air can up until the seal head air piston is inserted into the air can. Inject another 1 milliliter of Maxima Maxim 4 Extra 15W50 into the air can. Press the air can onto the damper, then thread it onto the shaft eyelet until it is hand tight. Spray isopropyl alcohol on the outside of the air can and clean it with a shop towel. Clamp the damper body eyelet in the vise. Stabilize the air can with a strap wrench to prevent it from rotating. Use a torque wrench with a 13mm Crowfoot to tighten the air can to 4.5 Nm. Spray isopropyl alcohol on the shock and clean it with a shop towel. Remove the shock from the vise. Install the sag indicator O-ring. Use the RockShox rear shock bushing removal and installation tool to press the bushing pin into the shock eyelet bushing until the pin protrudes from each side of the eyelet an equal amount. Press an end spacer large diameter first onto each end of the bushing pin. Use a shock pump to pressurize the shock to the desired air pressure. Install the shock to your bicycle frame according to the bicycle manufacturer's instructions. The air pressure will need to be equalized between the shock chambers. Slowly but firmly press or sit on the saddle to compress the shock until there is a hissing sound. This sound indicates air transfer between chambers. Reinstall the shock pump and record the air pressure. Add the amount of needed pressure, then unthread it from the shock. Repeat this process until you reach the desired amount of sag. Then install the valve cap. When pressurizing the shock, do not exceed the maximum pressure rating. The pump must be removed from the shock prior to checking sag to avoid damage to the pump and/or bicycle frame. This concludes the 50-hour air can service for RockShox rear shocks.